Thank you. Good morning, good morning, good morning to each and every one of you. Happy Sunday morning. Amen. Glory be to God. What a beautiful day it is. Amen. To be counted in a number. Amen. Come on, let's put our blessed hands together. Amen. Oh, we can do better than that. Amen. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. I know my voice kind of sound a little raspy. Amen. Glory be to God. But I thank God, amen, that he choose, amen, to shine his grace upon you and I. Amen. This morning. So come on, let's give God some good. God bless you this morning. Amen. Come on, let's stand on our feet. Amen. Those who are in the sanctuary, you that are viewing YouTube live, amen. Glory be to God. Either you at home or at work, amen. Glory be to God. Sometimes you just got to steal away. Amen. Go into the bathroom. Amen. Go into a secret place on your job and raise God. Give God some glory this morning, because he is worthy of all the glory, all the honor, and all the praise that is due unto your name. Amen. And as you continue to bless God, amen, as you continue to praise him, just gotta glory be to God. I want you, amen, this morning, amen, to share this link, amen. Give this link out to someone, amen. Glory be to God, because there's a word from the Lord this morning, amen, that will, amen, will challenge us, amen, that will cause us, amen, to will position us back unto Christ this morning, amen. Glory be to God, because we've seen too many people have fallen away from God. Amen. Glory be to God. But God loves us so much. Amen. Glory be to God, that he wants us to come back in alignment with his word. Amen. You got to know, amen, we cannot live this walk, this life, or walk this walk, amen, without the word of God, without God's presence. Amen. Glory be to God. Without God's grace being upon us. Amen. Glory be to God. Without God's Holy Spirit, amen, indwelling within us. Amen. Glory be to God, because it's the Holy Ghost, amen. Glory be to God, that will direct our path. Amen. The Holy Ghost, amen. Oh, glory be to God, will bring back to remembrance everything that God has spoken unto us in this hour. Amen. And we have the opportunity, amen, as sons and daughters of God, to raise our voice this morning. Amen. To shout out loud. Amen. To cry out. Amen. Glory be to God, to the God of our salvation. Amen. To the God of the Bible. Amen. El Shaddai himself. Amen. Almighty. Glory be to God. There's something to praise God about this morning. Amen. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. So I am grateful. Glory be to God. So God allowed me to stand in front of you this morning. Amen. Did you share this link? Amen. Glory be to God. I hope you did. Amen. I hope you are obedient, amen, to the voice of God this morning. Amen. Glory be to God. What an exciting day. Glory be to God. What an exciting first day of the week. Amen. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. What you do today, amen, will set precedence for you tomorrow and the days after. Amen. Did you hear me? Glory be to God. Let me repeat that. What you do today, the first day of the week, amen, is what's going to happen following the next week, days after. Amen. You start the precedence here today. Amen. If you start today praising and worshiping God, amen, glory be to God, throughout the week, amen, you should start your day with praising and worshiping God. Amen. Because that's going to set the tone for your life. Amen. Today is going to set the tone, glory be to God, for your life for the rest of your days. Amen. Glory be to God. So give God some praise this morning. Amen. Come on, why don't we praise him together? Amen. If we stand in the midst of an open heaven, which we do, amen, come on, we can praise God this morning. Amen. Glory be to God, for he's a great and mighty God. So we do thank God for you and each and every one of you who decided to click on this link and join us here at the U, the Underground Christian Center. We are eternally grateful, amen, unto God the Father this morning for you. Amen. And I'm expecting God to do some great and mighty things in you and through you because of your obedience. Amen. And I always like to open up in a moment of prayer. And prayer is always an essential part of the believer's life. Amen. Glory be to God. We cannot live without prayer. Amen. Prayer keeps us in a channel in God's anointing. Amen. As we go ahead and grace his throne and presence, most beautiful, gracious Father, we do thank and we praise you, Jesus, God, for just another day, another opportunity for that you allowed us to raise our voice, amen, to come into your presence with thanksgiving in our hearts, God, and in your courts with praise, knowing that you are the God of our salvation, knowing that you sit high and you look low, your eyes is on the righteous and your ears are attentive to our call. And we are grateful this morning today, God, that you called us in this beautiful koinonia, this fellowship with you today, God, to walk with you, to talk with you today, God. In the mighty name of Jesus, Father, we thank you for giving us our daily bread today, God. We thank you for giving us living even waters that we can drink today, God, in the name of Jesus, and that we never thirst again today, God. We thank you for your word this morning being marrow to our bones today, God, in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you by you strengthen us by your spirit and your might this morning today, God, in the mighty name of Jesus, that you unclog the deaf ears today, God, that we can hear in the spiritual realm today, God. Father, we thank you this morning that you anoint our eyes with eyes alive today, God, that we can see in the spiritual realms today, God, in the mighty name of Jesus. My God, we thank you for the giftings of the Holy Spirit today, God, in the name of Jesus, that comes with the gift of discernment today, God. Father, we thank you today, God, for you know exactly what we need today, God, and you supplied our needs of according to your riches and glory through Christ Jesus today, God. So we thank you today, God, that we stand in the midst of you today, God, a God that is glorious today, God, a God that's holy, a God that's righteous today, God. Father, we thank you today, God, that you called us today, God, in the name of Jesus, to be representations of you here in the earth from today, God. We thank you today, God, that we are ambassadors of Christ today, God, that we stand in your reference today, God, in the name of Jesus. We reference your holy name today, God. We stand as trees of righteousness today, God. We dismantle lies today, God, that enemy have sown in the lives of your people today, God, in the mighty name of Jesus. My God, you called us living epistles of you today, God. Therefore, we will walk out our callings today, God, our elections today, God, in the name of Jesus. My God, we bless your holy name today, God, for your presence being named known into our lives today, God, in the mighty name of Jesus. We thank you for the glory, God, descending in this place today, God, and remaining in the name of Jesus today, God. We thank you today, God, in the name of Jesus, with our hands lifted up today, God. We reverence your name today, God. We give you all the glory, all the honor, and all the praise that is due unto your name today, God. In the name of Jesus, my God, you the one get us to rightly divide your word of truth today, God. In the mighty name of Jesus, my God, that we can stand the forces and the tactics of the enemy today, God. That we can withstand the fiery darts today, God, that is onslaught in our minds today, God. That we can cast it down today, God. For you told us to cast every thought and every imagination and exalt the will of knowledge of you today, God. You told us to cast it down in your presence today, God. Wherefore, we will do that in the name of Jesus, my God. So we go into the atmosphere and the hemisphere today, God. We bind and rebuke every force, every tactic of the enemy today, God, that tries to shift us like wheat today, God. But we thank you today, God, that your word will set up a standard against the enemy today, God. So when the enemy want to come in like a flood today, God, you said your word will set up a standard against the enemy today, God. And we thank you today, God, in the name of Jesus, that we can rest and assure in you today, God, that we are triumphant in every area of our life today, God, in the name of Jesus, my God, that we no longer blinded, God, in the name of Jesus, but now we can see in the spiritual realm today, God, in the name of Jesus. And we take the offensive position today, God, in the name of Jesus, against the wiles and the tactics of the enemy today, God. We go into the enemy camps today, God. We take back what the enemy have stole today, God. In the name of Jesus, we shall not walk in fear today, God, but we will walk in spirit of love and truth and harmony with your spirit, God, in the mighty name of Jesus, my God. We thank you today, God, that we taken subdued in territories today, God, in the name of Jesus, my God. We thank you today, God, and in your word today, God, wherever our feet shall tread upon today, God, that's the land you have given unto us today, God, so to do it and to take it over today, God, in the mighty name of Jesus, my God. And we thank you for your word this morning today, God, coming out this place with boldness and authority today, God, in Jesus' name we pray, amen. Come on, let's put our blessed hands together. Oh, we could do better than that, amen. Oh, yes, we can, amen. Glory be to God, hallelujah. Once again, I do apologize to my voice, amen, going in and out, amen, but I hope and pray that you can hear me clearly, amen. Glory be to God, hallelujah. Sunday after Sunday, we do have our vision and mission statement here at the Underground Christian Center, here at the Underground Christian Center. As you can see on our back monitors, as well as our banners on my right and my left, those that's in the sanctuary, amen. But our vision statement is this: to become the greatest loving, sowing, and harvesting church for the kingdom of God, amen. Let's repeat our vision statement again to this. It is to become the greatest loving, sowing, and harvesting church for the kingdom of God. Amen. And our vision statement, amen, goes straight with our mission statement. Amen. And our mission statement is this: to sow the word of God into the hearts of all people, regardless of their race, culture, or financial position, in order to create a true Christian disciple. Amen. In order to create a true Christian disciple. Amen. We here at the Underground Christian Center, the U, amen, is determined, amen, to make true Christian disciples of each and every one of you. Amen. Glory be to God, because there's so many false teachers out there. Amen. All y'all can say amen. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. There is so many false teachers out there. Amen. And God is saying, glory be to God. He had placed in the earth realm, amen, teachers, ministers, amen, after his own heart, pastors, amen, that will feed his flock with his word, amen. Glory be to God, hallelujah. We bless his name, amen. Glory be to God, hallelujah. What a beautiful day it is, amen. If you never accepted the Lord Jesus Christ as your personal savior, today is the day, amen. Glory be to God for you to accept the Lord Jesus Christ as your personal savior, amen. If you're in a backsliding condition, amen, glory be to God, what a perfect day it is for you, amen, to be reinstated back into the body of Christ like you have never lost it before, amen. Because Romans 10, amen, verses 9 to 10 says this: if thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus and shalt believe in thy heart that God has raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. For with the heart man believe unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation, amen. Glory be to God, hallelujah. With our mouth, amen, confession is made unto salvation, amen. And all you have to do is say a powerful prayer and say like this: Father God, in the name of Jesus, I thank you today, God, that you saved me. Enter into my heart, enter into my mind. I thank you today, God, for your grace. I thank you that your only begotten son came down in the form of flesh, amen, to die, to redeem us back unto you. Father, I thank you today, God, in the name of Jesus, and I invite you even more in my life through the gifting of the Holy Spirit. I thank you for saving me, sanctifying me, and making me whole in you, amen. A beautiful amen prayer that I had just given, amen. If you sincere in your heart and mind, amen, and you touch and agree with that prayer, amen, welcome into the body of Christ, amen. Glory be to God. Oh, we can come on, we can put our blessed hands together. Oh, we too quiet this morning, amen. Glory be to God. We are too quiet for him this morning. Amen. Glory be to God. There's someone that was just saved. Amen. Someone would just pull out of Satan's grip. Amen. And brought into God's marvelous kingdom. Amen. If the heavens are rejoicing, amen, the people of God should be rejoicing also. Amen. Glory be to God. So come on, give God some glory this morning. Amen. Oh, come on. We can do that. Amen. We can't do that for the Lord this morning. Amen. Oh, we can, amen. And we do thank God, amen, for you, amen. And I'm excited for those, amen, that was in a backsliding condition, recommitted themselves back unto Christ. Welcome. You have been restored like you never was lost, amen. Like you never strayed away from God. You have been restored back to him. And we are grateful for each and every one of you, amen, had took the stand, amen, to accept the Lord Jesus Christ as your personal savior, amen. Glory be to God. We do thank and we praise God for his presence. Amen. Now we're in the tithes and offering section of the service. Amen. Glory be to God. Prepare to give unto the Lord. Amen. Prepare to receive God's anointing, God's blessing once you obey his voice. Amen. If God's telling you to tithe, amen, glory be to God, God only requiring 10%, amen, of all that you have earned. Amen. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. He can do more than that 10% that you could do, the 90% that he left in your hands. Amen. Glory be to God. And if God leading you, amen, just to give an offering, amen, praying to God, amen, let him touch your heart, amen, and say, how much do you want me to offer into your ministry, amen, glory be to God. And when you're obedient, amen, glory be to God for that number that he puts in your mind, glory be to God, be obedient and give. Don't allow the enemy to snatch your blessings out of you, amen, because when God starts speaking, amen, the enemy is right there, amen, to discourage you of not to doing what God had told you to do, amen. The enemy comes to try to block your blessings, amen, glory be to God. But if you heard a dollar amount in your spirit, amen, give that, amen. Don't listen to the devil, amen. Don't listen to him saying don't you give, amen. He wants to block your blessings, amen. But if you give, watch God bless you, amen. Now you're in the tithes or offering section, amen. And when you come back, amen, I'm going to break the bread of life with you, amen. Oh, Man, amen. We do thank God and we bless God for your obedience. Amen. We pray for 100-fold blessings be returned unto you because of your obedience. Amen. You had listened to the word of God. Amen. Glory be to God. And we thank God for each and every one of you this morning. Amen. This morning, I'm going to share with you, glory be to God, briefly the word of God. And it's entitled Hold Fast. Hold Fast. Sunday after Sunday, I do ask the Lord, what do you have to give to me so I can give unto your people? Amen. And I tell you without a fail, amen, God always give you a word. Amen. When you ask in sincerity of heart, amen, God will give you a word. Amen. Glory be to God. That will charge you, to make you stand assured on his word, to make you know that he is in the midst of you. Amen. Glory be to God. And he don't want his people astray from him. Amen. He knows that his people haven't strayed for him too far. Amen. And far too long. Amen. So this morning, amen, if I can hold your ear, amen, if you can lend me your ear for just a couple of minutes this morning, amen, I won't be before you long, I promise you. Amen. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. And this word this morning that I'm going to, amen, speak to you about is hold fast. Hold fast. We are living in a time and season where we see the devil dynamic activities waxing worse and worse. We see that the devil has now targeted our preschoolers to introduce their minds to perversion by putting same-sex marriage in cartoons like Peppa the Pig, who is the latest cartoon geared towards the preschool audience that has introduced the spirit of perversion. Glory be to God. The devil wants to intellectualize our young children's minds in believing that it's all right for a man to be a man with a man and a woman to be with a woman. We're living in perilous times, and we as Christians, as the body of Christ, cannot compromise with Satan. When we compromise with the devil just a little, we saying we are agreeing with dynamic spirits in the works of darkness. The word of God clearly advises in Galatians chapter 5, verses 9, that a little leaven leavened the whole lump. In other words, what he's saying is that when we compromise with the devil, we are compromising with our stance with God. And the enemy can now toy with your mind to have you succumb to other things that is contrary to the word of God. People of God, this is the time for those that are Christians to hold fast to God like never before and hold fast to the provision that Christ Jesus have divided us to do. Amen. When you've been institutionalized in your mind, you are believing in a set rule that's being established in your thought. You've been repeatedly influenced by whatever trying to institutionalize you, whether good or bad. When you look at the word institutionalized, it means to establish in practice or customs. Oh, glory be to God. Let me repeat institutionalism. It means to establish in practice or customs. It's like that someone who has been in prison lastly for however long, that person begins to adapt to the prison mindset. Amen. Glory be to God. That person tends to do like all other people have been doing that's around them. Amen. That person has been institutionalized by the penal system. Amen. To guard the way they think, they took on the custom of the mindset of a prison mindset. See, when you're being institutionalized in your mind, and we should all know by now what our mind consists of, which is your will, intellect, and your emotions. You've been accustomed to whatever that is trying to get your mind to accepting a certain customs that's been established, like the enemy. He's trying to institutionalize our mind to accepting what is perverse unto God. Amen. Glory be to God. And by him doing that, he's introducing it, and by he's inducing it through what? Movies. He's introducing through commercials. Amen. Now he said went as far as to go ahead and attack the preschoolers. Amen. Those 3 and 4 year olds. Amen. Glory be to God. So he can institutionalize their mind. Glory be to God. To custom believing one way and doing one thing, accepting the spirit of perversion. But we as men and women of God, amen. Glory be to God that knows the truth. Amen. We have to stand, amen, on behalf of our young people. Amen. We got to stand on behalf of our children, our grandchildren, and those that even have great grandchildren. We have to stand on it, amen, and fout the wiles of the devil, amen. Glory be to God, and tell the devil, no, you cannot institutionalize my children, my grandchildren, my great grandchildren to accepting that spirit of perversion. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. We bless the name of the Lord, amen. See, when you've been institutionalized in your mind, and we see, show, like I said, how your mind consists of. It's just your will, intellect, and emotion. You've been accustomed to whatever that is trying to get your mind to accept in a certain custom that's been established. The only institution that we as Christians ought to be is in the Word of God. We should be institutionalized with the Word of God and the Word of God alone. Amen. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. God is calling his people back to normalcy with him. At one point in time, we as the body of Christ, Christians, hold fast the profession of what was written in the Bible. We stood on biblical principles that sharpened and molded us. But as for the body of believers, have lost sight on what the Bible says to say to come from them and be ye separated. Somehow the body of Christ has started to become in a perpetual sin motion. Amen. Against God. Amen. And if you turn to chapter 8, verses 5, amen, glory be to God, hallelujah. Jeremiah is talking to the people, amen, glory be to God, and he's asking this question, amen, are you there with Jeremiah? Chapter 8, verses 5, it says, why has this people backslidden, Jerusalem, in a perpetual backsliding? They're hold fast to deceit. They refuse to return unto God, amen. God is saying, amen, we need to return unto him, amen. We cannot hold fast to the deceitfulness. Amen. He's saying, return unto me. Amen. He wants us to return back to normalcy with him. Amen. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Because we stood at one point. Amen. We stood as rocks. Amen. Glory be to God. We stood as Peter. Amen. Glory be to God. When God said, called him a rock. Amen. And upon this rock. Amen. He said he will build his church and the very gates of hell should not prevail against it. What happened to the church? Amen. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Why hasn't it hold fast to God's word? Amen. What have happened? Amen. Why are we in a perpetual backsliding condition? Amen. Is it because of our sinful ways? Yes. Glory be to God. Is our disobedience? Oh, yes. It's our disobedience for the word. Amen. Is it us grabbing hold to the enemy? Amen. Glory be to God. Giving the enemy a little. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. A little leaven. Didn't I say it? Hallelujah. We'll leaven the whole bunch, the whole lump. Amen. When we give the enemy just a little bit, amen. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. He comes in like a flood. Amen. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. But when you examine the word normalcy, it's a state of being normal, usually or expected. When someone returns to a state of normalcy, it's returning to the way it ought to be. Amen. Glory be to God. It's the way that it ought to be. Hallelujah. So God is saying, return back to me. Hold fast, amen, to the profession which you have called in Christ Jesus at one point of your time. Come back to normalcy with me. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. In the book of Jeremiah, chapter 22, verses 5. In the book of Joshua, chapter 22, verses 5, Joshua warned the people to continue to hold fast to the Lord your God, as they, the children of Israel, has done in the past. So turn with me to Joshua, chapter 22, verses 5. Joshua 22, verses 5, amen. And if you don't have your word, amen, glory be to God, write these scriptures down, amen. And I want you to pray, amen, unto God, amen, so he can give you more and more, glory be to God, and reveal more unto you. Amen. Glory be to God. But since we are a word church, we always tell you, glory be to God, to bring your sword, to bring your battle axe, amen, with you. Amen. Because you always want to go with the man or woman of God who is breaking God's word unto you. Amen. So Joshua chapter 22 verses 5 said this, but take careful heed to do the commandment and the law which Moses, the servant of the Lord, commanded you, to love the Lord your God, to walk in all his ways, to keep his commandments, to hold fast to him, and to serve him with all your heart and with all your soul. Now, you probably say, Pastor P, amen. Glory be to God. That's the Old Testament. Amen. Glory be to God. We're in the new dispensation of Christ. Amen. Yes, we are. Amen. Glory be to God. But the old and the new come together. Amen. Jesus said that I've come, amen, not to do away or abolish the law. Amen. But he came to fulfill the law. Amen. So whatever's written in the law, amen. Glory be to God. God has already fulfilled it. Amen. Glory be to God. And that law is still working in order today through Jesus Christ. Amen. Glory be to God. So those two come into contact with one another. Amen. Glory be to God. He said for us, wait a minute, to love the Lord thy God with all our heart and with all our soul, with all our might, to walk in all his ways and to keep his commandments. Amen. Joshua chapter 23, verses 8. Amen. Turn the page over just once. Amen. That's Joshua chapter 23, verses verses 8, and it says the exact same thing. It says, but you shall hold fast to the Lord your God as you have done to this day. Amen. Joshua had to constantly remind the children of Israel to hold fast to what they know, what is right and befitting. Apostle Paul also told young Timothy to stand as a bold soldier in Jesus Christ and to hold fast in 2 Timothy 2. Amen. Glory be to God. There's a reason why God always tells us to hold fast. Amen. Glory be to God, to hold fast in the word of God. Amen. Because there's going to be a time, amen, whether this is going to be a real dark time, and that is coming soon. Amen. And God is telling his people to hold fast unto him. No matter what, hold on to the horns of the altar. Amen. Hold on to God. Amen. Glory be to God. Because we're entering in dark channels. We're entering in dark waters. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. But the light of Jesus Christ, the light of the gospel of Jesus Christ, amen, will be our navigator through this dark time that we're in. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. And God is saying, hold fast, my children. Hold fast to myself. Amen. Hold fast to my commandments. Hold fast to my word. Hold fast to my sayings. Amen. Because it's our hour is coming. Amen. Glory be to God. Where darkness will shadow. Amen. This whole earth as we see today. A blanket of deception. Amen. Is all over the world. Amen. Glory be to God. And you don't want to be caught up in it. You don't want to be blinded in the deception. Amen. Of the enemy. Amen. That's why we got to hold fast unto God. Glory be to God. We have to hold fast unto him, to our dear life. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. We bless the Lord this morning. He's telling, he's crying out to his people to come back unto me. Come back unto me. Come to first what you first did. Come back to your first love. Come back and stay with me. Hold fast to my word. Hold fast to my teachings like never before. And watch me guide you in this dark time. Because dark times is coming, saints. We in a dark time now. But glory be to God. But there's going to be a darker day. Glory be to God, where we wouldn't see the forest through the trees. We wouldn't be able to see our hand in the front of our face, but the Spirit of the Lord, amen, will illuminate in darkness. His word will be a lamp unto our feet, a light unto our path. His word will guide us in these dark times. So hold fast to the confession in Jesus Christ, amen. So come on, let's put our blessed hands together, amen. Amen, amen. I sure hope you got something from the word of God this morning. Amen. I went over Joshua, Jeremiah. Amen. Chapter 8, verses 5. Amen. That's Jeremiah, chapter 8, verses 5. I went through Joshua, chapter 22, verses 5. Joshua 23, verses 8. Amen. And I want you to go over this lesson, amen, 2 to 3 times. Amen. I want you to go over these biblical verses. Amen. I want you to remove from that television. I want you to get away from that radio station. Amen. Because it's clouding your heart. It's clouding your ears. It's clouding you. It's taking up too much space. And you don't need that space to be taken up. Amen. Because we're living in a dark time. Amen. And the times is going to get even darker. And glory be to God. Hallelujah. And the news people will not be able to help you in that hour. Those talk shows will not be able to help you in those hours. That telephone, that television personality will not help you in this hour. You need the word of God, amen. You need the word of God to be the ever-burning candle in your spirit, amen, so you can see. Glory be to God, hallelujah, when the darkness will overshadow each and every one of us, amen. Glory be to God, even the more, amen. There's a darker day coming, amen. But God says, hold on to your confession in me, in Jesus Christ. I will never leave you nor forsake you. Glory be to God. When your back is against the wall, amen, look for me, amen. I'll be your light in times of trouble. I'll be your light in your dark hour, amen. Glory be to God. Don't leave God in this hour. Glory be to God, because there's dark times in ahead of us even the more. Times that we never seen before. We thought we would never see in this time and day, amen, that the enemy is coming after our children as early as 2 and 3 years old. Can you imagine the plan, what he's trying to do, amen? Glory be to God, out of the womb, amen? Glory be to God, I guaranteed, hallelujah, it's going to play a part in the minds of their parents, amen. When a child is born, amen, they're going to say, oh, I wish it was a boy. They're going to try to, glory be to God, do some insane things, amen. Things that our mind never thought of, amen. That's of the devil, amen, glory be to God. If he's hitting at our 2 and 3 and 4 year olds, amen, I can imagine what he's going to do, amen, when the darkest of nights come, upon each and every one of us. Glory be to God. But hold fast to God. Amen. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. There is light in darkness. And we do thank God. Amen. Glory be to God this morning. Father God, we thank you for your word. Amen. To hold fast. Amen. We thank you today, God, in the name of Jesus, that you will see us through trying times. Glory be to God. Times of darkness. Amen. Glory be to God. We look towards you, our help, God. We look towards the hills, and with our help is coming from you. And our help come from you, oh Lord God, the one that created the heaven and earth and all that possesses. So Father, I thank you today, God, in the name of Jesus, my God, that we would be like the wise virgins, amen, keeping our light aflame, glory be to God, keeping oil in our lamps today, God, that it would never burn out, God. We thank you for your word, God. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Let's put our blessed hands together. Amen, amen. We could do better than that. Amen. The doors of the church are open. And if anyone desires to join Team Jesus and be a part of the Underground Christian Center, we invite you to do this at this time. This ministry is focused on doing the will of God and his will alone. If you would like to join a part of the Underground Christian Center, then please drop a message in the live chat and state, I want to be a part of God's work here at the Underground Christian Center. Those that are in the sanctuary, you can do so by the showing of your hands. Amen. Also, you can reach us by phone at the church number at 302-553-1589, and we will reach back out to you. Amen. And the church number, once again, is area code 302-553-1589. And you can also reach us by P.O. Box 493 Smyrna, Delaware, 19977. Once again, that's P.O. Box 493 Smyrna, Delaware, 19977. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. I hope, amen, that your day this week that you have started, amen, glory be to God, but will be a glorious week, amen, of praise and worship and adoration unto the Lord, amen. Know that we love you here at the UD Underground Christian Center, knowing that we're praying for you, amen, and we pray, God, to good success for you in the Lord, amen. Until next time, be blessed and know that we love you. Bye-bye.